It's very important that we start recognising where we are actually at as a species.
In Africa, 12-year-old boy soldiers kill their neighbours with AK-47 rifles.
The leaders do not talk about spreading out compassion in the world.
In China, 7,000 magnificent moon bears are imprisoned in steel coffins welded shut.
Everyone would fairly say they're concerned about the future of humanity.
In Canada, 300,000 baby seal pups are clubbed and skinned alive on the ice, their tiny hearts still beating.
Think bigger than you've ever thought before.
In Korea, dogs are beaten to death in the marketplace.
Well, I love my dog, and I treat my dog, look at me, I'm a compassionate person, and then you come home and eat some baby lamb. A creature equally as emotional, sensitive, feeling.
To our shame, in Australia, our animals are sent on death ships to the Middle East, where their eyes are stabbed out and their tendons are slashed.
We're picking and choosing where we want to apply our compassion.
We kill the premature dairy calves by crushing their rib cages until they break their hearts.
Would it be condoned by society for me to say that we should eat Down syndrome people because they're weaker than us, so we have the right, therefore, to take advantage and abuse their lives?
Billions of bouncy little baby chicks are ground up in mechanical mincers every day.
And this is not about does it taste good or not. This is about making the link between the action and the reality.
The commandment, thou shalt not kill, applies to the murder of any living being.
We are facing one of the most crucial times we've ever, ever been in as a species. This is real. You are looking at one of the most revolting things you could ever, ever imagine happening on a planet. That billions of animals are manipulated, controlled, abused, used, and destroyed by people that don't care about their lives.
We torture and kill 3 billion sentient animals every week.
What we're witnessing today is probably one of the most heinous crimes in the history of humanity.
It is a crime against humanity of unimaginable proportions.
It's not like we can't see it. But the thing is, we're not feeling it.
How do you see the world? I see it feelingly.
So I'm on a journey that's increasing compassion, which will lead to more love, more trust, more caring, more sharing, more honesty, and more beauty on planet Earth.
If you look at my shoes, my belt, and even my watch band, there are no animal products in anything that I use.
You know, we even have people like Sam Neill, who was a man I had some respect for as an actor, and he seemed like an intelligent man, who runs around now with orangutans, convincing an orangutan that the intelligent choice is to eat meat.
Believe me, milk today is the new asbestos. And Sam Neill, the scumbag, is the new Marlboro man.
If you want to unleash intelligence, unleash your compassion.
The optimum amount of meat in a healthy human diet is precisely zero.
The meat and dairy industries are powerful. They are controlling and manipulating society and taking us away from compassion.
We now know that forest depletion because of livestock costs us 3 times as much every year as the recent global financial crisis.
Compassion is the most expansive space of existence you could ever imagine existing in.
The brutes and the bullies have been Goliath. But David is coming.
It can be explained. There are reasons why.
Maybe he is one of you.
There are reasons. And until we understand what those reasons are, it will continue just slowly growing like this, and we don't have time for that anymore. And the reason I say that, because these animals, as we stand here today, are in agony. And that is not okay.
100,000 animals are killed every 7 seconds.
We've got to unite through the understanding of what it is we're actually saying.
There are 600 million vegetarians in the world, and that is bigger than the United States, England, France, Germany, Italy, Canada, and Australia.
So let's all get together and let's find some strength, and let's work out how to make some real change in this world.
If we were one nation, we would be bigger than the 27 nations of the European Union. And despite this massive demographic footprint, we are still drowned out by the raucous hunt and shoot and kill and cretins who believe that violence is the answer when it should not even be a question.
They haven't had the courage to step up and face life beyond self, because to look beyond yourself, it can be quite scary.
They all genuinely want to change the world, as long as they don't have to change themselves.
Watch those videos, see the truth, find out what it looks like, feel it all.
Never doubt that a few committed people can change the world. Indeed, that is the only thing that ever has.
It's having the courage to realize that you have to lead the way. And this is not about telling people that they're wrong. It's about inspiring them to what lives beyond this.
So if we, good people, double our efforts just a few times, we can change the world.
Either you're compassionate or you're not. It's not something you can put in convenient boxes and say, I'm a really nice person, but I like killing and eating animals.
We must redefine the meaning of the word food, or redefine the meaning of the word cannibal.
If we don't unite, it's becoming very clear where we're heading. We're going to battle our way to our own demise.
The great historian Barbara Tuchman defined folly, stupidity, as acting against our own best interests.
Who would like to see a compassionate world where we actually cared for each other, for real? Is it obvious? Seems obvious, but it's not happening.
Socrates was right. The unexamined life is not worth living. It's not a life at all, it's a life sentence.
This is the journey of humanity. This is the journey of sharing, the journey of connecting. This is the journey of having courage. Courage to speak up and say no, this is not okay.
The animal rights is the greatest social issue since the abolition of slavery.
Well, right now the human race is committing the biggest, most kept underground secret ever in the history of humanity.
Are we to live forever in a sick and smug, cruel past? One thing is for sure, the past has not served us well, and we are not bound by it. If we continue the past, we have no future.
This is not a debate. There is no debate in this.
This calamity will reshape the geopolitical landscape forever.
And you should be able to see how ridiculous it is that we don't stop this right now.
These vile, hideous torture chambers must be torn down. They have no place in civilized society.
What I would like to encourage any living, thinking, breathing human being to do is to try looking at life without relying on any past thought that they've ever had. Forget the past, because the past is an accumulation of thoughts that builds a network, a link, bunch of things from your life experience. The past is not something we should be using to guide anything other than to know that whatever we're doing is creating more mess, more destruction and more cruelty. So in knowing that, isn't that a good enough reason to not go back into it and to completely, imagine it, just temporarily, just sever the past from your mind, which takes out the concept of self as well, where that was built, which allows you now to look at things from a pure state. Therefore, you can look at animal cruelty, human cruelty, the destruction of the environment, the rudeness that we are towards each other. We can just look at it for what it is. Let's forget the judgments, the rights and wrongs, who's contributing to it, who's the worst person, which leader should we get rid of. Let's forget everything, just temporarily. And it'd be intriguing for human beings just to look at what collectively we've allowed to happen. There's 600 million vegetarians on the planet, and to think that we're still drowned out by the majority. Completely drowned out. Wouldn't feel like, percentage-wise, let's say that's around 10%, doesn't feel like a 10% voice. It feels like about a 0.0001% voice. You feel completely, you feel like everywhere you look, you're drowned out by the others and what they do. Because they're all about progression and control, and so they're more forceful in their approach to life. So of course they're drowning it out. But if everyone could just stop for a second, forget the past and have a look, I think we'd all see the same thing. Let's just have a look at what we have collectively created, including the good people who haven't done enough. They haven't said no. They haven't led the way. They haven't showed people what's going on and this has to stop. Not enough, obviously. That's the facts. For them to admit that, for everyone just to be honest about the reality of what we've created. And I still think the animal issue is enough. To think we have such a thing called a slaughterhouse? Where people are employed to grab an animal, use electric prods to force it to go where they want, to jam bolts in their heads, to slice their throats up, hang them from chains and watch them die as blood drips out of their throat and their legs kick desperately. To think that even exists in the numbers that it does. We're not talking about there's a few bad people around that do that. We're talking about this is the norm. If we can't stop and look at that and say, holy crap, what have we done? If we can't face that, we will not be able to face anything. And that can only happen if we forget the past, because in the past is where all of our justifications were created. That's why it's like that. So the past creates a deluded sense of glasses to look through, and then we can tell ourselves anything. I guarantee you, if you could just plonk everyone completely in this moment, but not in a moment for self-indulgent, like is living in the now where we're like, you know, oh, I just can be happy and free, and you know, they don't run around being compassionate. I'm talking about living in the now via looking at the truth and how ugly it has become. That's a different kind of being in the now. That's a wake up being in the now. I'm convinced that would do it if we just look. Forget theories, forget philosophies, forget possibilities, forget psychology, forget everything. Just honestly look at what we have done. Because I think deep down everyone cares, because you can see they care for certain things. So the caring is there, they would like to care. They would like to be loved. They would like to give love. Every living being, you can see that. Every animal, you give it a chance to be loved, it just laps it up. It loves it and it loves the whole process. Everything does. But we'll never ever feel that or share that if we're not prepared to look at the insane cruelty that we've created on this planet.
Statistics show that as many as 140 billion animals are killed every year for human consumption as food, clothing, entertainment and research. The overwhelming majority of these animals are forced to live in horrendous conditions. Yet even those that are so-called free range or raised on organic farms are still subjected to be killed against their will. No living creature wishes to die. And death is arguably the greatest fear of any human. Yet we subject 3 billion living creatures every week to our most feared fate. We unnecessarily feed and clothe ourselves and our children with the products of cruel and violent habits.